Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hi, I'm Erlina Dwi Setiani and you can call me Elin. And in this video, I will talk about paralinguistic phenomena. So, what is paralinguistic? Paralinguistic is the study of this vocal, sometimes non-vocal, signals beyond the basic verbal message or speech. Paralinguistic include volume, speech rate, accent, pitch, fluency and modulation. Some researchers also certain non-vocal phenomena under the heading of paralanguage, like facial expressions, hand gestures, body movement, and etc. The rise in recent decades of non-face-to-face communication through email, text messaging, and social media led to the use of the emoticons as a substitute of paralanguage. Okay, next. When do we use paralanguage? We use paralanguage or paralinguistic when we gasp, sigh, clear our throat, change our tone, whisper or shout, and emphasize certain words. Or when we frown or smile, laugh or cry, string vocal identifiers like aha between our words, or speak fast or slower. Okay, next, there are two features of paralinguistic. The first is vocal paralinguistic features and the second is body paralinguistic features. The first is vocal paralinguistic features relate to how we say something. Speaking loudly and softly are characteristic of volume. A high tone can indicate nervousness or a question and even anger in some people. The second point is body paralinguistic feature. How we communicate meaning through the use of our body, like facial expressions, when we frown, smile, raise eyebrows, etc. These all share different forms of information. The next is gestures. Crossing out arms send a message. Scratching our heads indicates confusion or lack of communicating. Next is proximity. It is how close people are when communicating. The closer the two people are, the more intimate the conversation is. The last is posture. Slouching indicates laziness. When a person holds his head down, it is often a sign of inferiority. If a person stands with hunched shoulder, it sends a message as well. Okay, the next point is examples and observation. According to David Abercrombie, we speak with our vocal organs, but we converse with our entire bodies. Fenomena paralinguistik terjadi bersama dalam bahasa lisan, berinteraksi dengannya dan menghasilkan bersama dengan sistem komunikasi total. Studi tentang perilaku paralinguistik adalah bagian dari studi percakapan. Penggunaan percakapan bahasa lisan tidak dapat dipahami kecuali elemen paralinguistik diperhitungkan. And next, according Owen Hargi, Christine Saunders, and David Dixon, paralinguistic is commonly referred to as that which is for left after subtracting the verbal content from speech. Kelas itu sederhana, bahasa adalah apa yang dikatakannya, paralinguistik adalah bagaimana hal itu dikatakan membingungkan, karena seringkali bagaimana sesuatu dikatakan menentukan arti yang tepat dari apa yang dikatakan tersebut. Okay, the last is vocal and non-vocal phenomena. According John Lyons, the more technical discussion of what is loosely described as tone of voice involves the recognition of a whole set of variations in the feature of voice dynamics. Loudness, tempo, pitch, fluctuation, continuity, etc. Ini adalah masalah pengamatan harian bahwa pembicara akan cenderung berbicara lebih keras dan dalam nada tinggi yang tidak biasa ketika dia sedang bersemangat atau dalam keadaan marah. Di antara fenomena non-vokal yang paling jelas dapat diklasifikasikan sebagai paralinguistik dan memiliki modulasi yang selain diselingi. Contohnya, mengangguk dalam budaya tertentu, mengangguk dengan atau tanpa ekspresi mengartikan bahwa seseorang setuju akan sesuatu hal. Poin umum yang terus-menerus ditekankan dalam literatur adalah bahwa fenomena vokal dan non-vokal adalah berada pada tingkat pembelajaran yang relatif besar dari naluri dan berbeda-beda dari bahasa ke bahasa, atau mungkin harus dikatakan dari budaya ke budaya. Okay, I think that's all my explanation about paralinguistic phenomena. Thanks for watching and wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.